Hi, this is Mato. Welcome to my online chess lecture. In this video, I will show you a game between Roman Edward and Hannes Stefansson. This is a game from the European Team Championship played in Batumi, Georgia in 2019. Edward had white pieces and he started with d4. Stefansson played knight to f6, bishop to f4, b6, knight to c3, intending e4, maybe. Bishop to b7, controlling e4 square, f3, insisting on e4, d5, e4, e6, knight to b5, threatening knight takes on c7, knight to a6, the only good move for black, e5, attacking the knight and gaining the space on the board, knight to d7, bishop to e3, intending f4, c6, kicking the knight back, knight to c3, knight to c7, f4. Black to move. In positions like this, French defense players love to play c5, attacking white center. The Nimtso Indian defense players would play bishop to b4. Stefansson played f5. White to move. Should white take en passant or not? Players who enjoy playing a closed game would play knight to f3. Knight to f3 is a pretty good move. Edward played pawn takes pawn en passant. Knight takes on f6. Knight to f3. The knight is on the way to e5. Bishop to d6. Knight to e5. Castling queen to f3. c5. Queen to h3 attacking the pawn on e6. Defending. White to move. Perhaps bishop to e2 was expected. a4 was played. Maybe intending knight to b5, bishop to a6, offering to exchange his less valuable light squared bishop for more valuable white light squared bishop, bishop to d3. Perhaps knight to b5 was the original idea. Bishop to d3 was played, bishop takes on d3, c takes on d3. Black to move. This is very important moment of the game. What would you do in this position if you had black pieces? Player with the black pieces chopped the knight. Not the best move. Better was knight to h5. And if now castling, then c takes on d4. And if bishop takes on d4, rook takes on f4, and black is better. And let's go back. Instead of castling, if knight to e2, then c takes on d4, if bishop goes to d2, then knight to a6, and black is doing well. Back to our game. Bishop takes on e5 was played. Well, probably hoping for f takes on e5, d takes on e5 was played. If f takes on e5, knight to d7, and white can castle kingside, black is fine. Back to our game. D takes on e5 was played. You don't always have to capture towards the center. And player with the white pieces was not afraid of black's next move. d4. Decisions, decisions. Which piece to save? What would you do? Edward played e takes on f6. Black to move. This is now the most critical moment of the game. How should black continue? Rook takes on f6 was played. Better was d takes on e3. And after f takes on g7, rook takes on f4. Black is in the game. Back to our game. Rook takes on f6 was played. Player with the black pieces missed something in his calculations. And that is, he missed this move. Knight to e4. Attacking the rook. Play with the black pieces Stefansson designed. For the entertainment purpose, I will show you just one line. D takes on e3. Knight takes on f6, check. Pawn takes knight. Queen takes on e3. Knight to d5. Queen to e4. Rook to d8, castling. You can argue that black can fight from this position. Yes, you can. But player with the black pieces was angry at himself. It is hard to play if you're angry at yourself. Did it ever happen to you? If it did, you would understand. What do you think of this game? And that is all. I hope that you enjoyed watching this video. I wish you good luck with your chess, and bye for now.